I'm stuck. Hello? Hello? Anyone? Hello? Can you hear me? Help me! I'm stuck. Hello? Hello? Anyone?
Ah, hello. How nice it is to see a friendly face. As you can surmise, I've got myself stuck in another hole. Would you mind helping me out again? My thanks in advance. I know you're the man for the job. You know what to do, hmm? Give me a good smack from behind with something nice and big. Don't worry about my wound sustained at the festival. I'm stuck back together good and proper. Just give it your all.
Please! Wait. I have a terrible feeling about this. Would you stop hitting me for a minute?
I can feel my lower half is stuck on something. I don't think you can get me out just by hitting me this time. Let's think. Perhaps there's a way to slide me out a little more smoothly. What if I could somehow be made slippery or some such? My thanks to you and your razor-sharp wits. Oh, as a token of my thanks, I'd like you to have this. Oh, dearie me, I'm oilier than a toad. Yeah, there were countless oil jars back where I'm from, actually. And now I know what it's like to be one of them. Yes, indeed. I too have, though it is one to pow. I can feel to walk the path I'm headed. I can strengthen, I will forge.
your seamster, Bok. He is always eager to see your return. Please, will you talk to him when you can? I'm sure he would be much contented.
Bok the Seamster, at your service, Master. Ready to make adjustments to your garments. Master, my apologies. Your wardrobe includes the garb of the old demigods, and I'm afraid I can't make adjustments to them. My mum told me once that a royal seamster would do them up in a jiffy. Just wait, Master. Before long, I'll be that good too. Is that a gift for my undeserving self? Thank you kindly. But what on earth could it... Oh, what... amazing! I've never seen a golden needle. Not in all my life. With a spectacular royal crest to boot, are you certain that this is for me? Oh, I can hardly believe it. Have faith in me, Master. I'll polish my craft enough that I deserve this golden gift. I'll be the golden seamster, Bok. Now I'll be able to sew anything, even the threads of the demigods. Do you think that Mum would be pleased if she knew that I'm as good as any royal seamster now? Oh, it's still not enough. I need to learn how to sew from scratch like her. Oh, going so soon? Please do be safe on your journeys.
You finally come. Blythe told me everything. You've defeated General Radahn, unlocking the stars. The general was blighted by scarlet rot and driven to madness. But not long ago, he was hailed as the mightiest demigod of them all. There is no parallel to your achievement, nor to Lady Rani's acute judgment of character. Thanks to you, Lady Rani's fate once again stirs, and the path to Nokron has opened. Descend underground, where the fallen star struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron. Oh, Blythe wanted me to tell you not to bother waiting for him. And head straight to Nokron. Blythe has been given an important task. Apparently, a matter of great urgency. You need not await, Blythe. Descend underground alone, with a fallen star-struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron, so that Lady Rani may tread the dark path of the Empyrean. You need not await, Blythe. Descend underground alone, with a fallen star-struck Limgrave, and make it yours. The precious treasure of Nokron, so that Lady Rani may tread the dark path of the Empyrean. You need not descend underground and make it yours so that Lady.
My thanks, friend. I'm going to see Mistress Rani now. I don't know what came over old Eiji, but even if the odds are slim, I need to check the mistress is safe. Now, Rani can finally set in motion the fight against her fate she's dreamt of for so long. I'm going to see Mistress Rani now. I don't know what came over old Eiji, but even if the odds are slim, I need to check the mistress is safe. I'm going to see Mistress. I don't know what, but even if the odd.
Greeting. I presume you've spoken with Blythe? Very well. There is something you should know. The Two Fingers gave Blythe to Lady Rani as a faithful follower. Her very shadow, incapable of treachery. But if Lady Rani, as an Empyrean, resists being an instrument of the Two Fingers, the shadow will go mad, transforming from a follower into a horrid curse. But such is his destiny. In such matters, Blythe's own thoughts hold no weight. It pains me so. But he must be neutralized. For Lady Rani's sake.
You. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. Ah, you. Please, leave me be.
Found another great room. Wonderful. You are a worthy fellow tarnished indeed. Make the journey to the capital, Lanedale, that lies to the east of the Altus Plateau, at the foot of the Erd Tree. The Two Fingers will deny your passage no longer. You may be our best hope. Find your way to the Elden Ring, for we are tarnished, and we must answer the call of grace. You've already heard. Indeed, it seemed the whelp harbored suspicions, so I had no further use for her. Honestly, what a man to do. A determined plebeian is more wicked than an omen horn, quite frankly. I suspect that's just what the Queen wants. A dose of ambition to incite the tarnished.
You. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. So you know already, do you? Right. It's true. My father cast me out for indulging my emotions, forgetting the mission. Punishment for offing his pawns. Father, mother, Lord Gideon has offered me guidance all my life. I would have done anything for him, to place him on the throne of Elden Lord. And yet I, though it was not my intent, I betrayed him. And I can no longer trust him, Father. To think he'd order his men to enact such tragedy. Where is the justice he purports in that? He once told me that if he became Elden Lord, he would never allow the downtrodden to be cheated ever again. Was he simply lying to me? No, no, no. How could I say that? Father has always given me his guidance. And now, I've lost it. Is that ash? I can smell the ancient storm in it. My thanks. I'll gladly take it. I'm not like Roderica. I don't feel the presence of spirits, let alone see them. Still, this ash, it reminds me of my first hawk. Thank you.
Beep. Thank you.